Good morning, friends, and welcome to the Morning Tales for June 21, 2019. As we all are aware of the significance of the current affairs, that these current affairs not only help you in cracking the objective examinations such as the phase 1 of RBI, SEBI and NABARD, but also helps in phase 2 as well as phase 3, that is the interview round. So recently there is this meeting of the Niti Aayog's governing council, and this was the 5th meeting of the council, which has concluded in Delhi. And in that council, PM Modi has made a remarkable statement by setting up the agenda to make India a 5 trillion economy by 2024. Another important development which had taken place during the Niti Aayog's governing council meeting was the agenda to transform the agricultural sector by reforming Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee as well as Essential Commodities Act. So now the question for you is that when was Essential Commodities Act enacted? This is a very common act and you can easily Google it. So do mention your answers in the comment section below so that we can get an idea that you are regularly engaging in the current affairs. Moving on to the first question of our Morning Tales. Which state had launched the Mukhya Mantri Jal Swavalamban Abhiyan to protect water? A factual and a very important question from exam point of view. So there are 5 options, that is Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana. So out of these 5 options, the option A, that is Rajasthan, is the right answer. So now why is this scheme important? This scheme is important because recently Narendra Modi had appreciated these 5 states for implementing the unique initiatives in order to promote and conserve the waters. So Maharashtra has launched the Jal Ayukt Shivar in Maharashtra, Rajasthan's Mukhya Mantri Jal Swavalamban Abhiyan. Another important scheme is Telangana's Mission Kakatiya, which irrigates around 19 lakh acres of land. Another important scheme is Gujarat's Sujalam Sufalam and Karnataka's Artificial Recharge Scheme. Who will head the committee formed by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas for reviewing the LPG market structure? Again, there are 5 options. So out of these 5 options, option C, that is Kirit Parekh, is the right answer. Now this committee is very important from exam point of view. Why? It has been formed in order to check the loopholes in the existing market structure so that if there is any possibility to involve the private players. Private players as in private companies in the subsidized LPG market. So if this plan goes on, so there are high chances that companies like Reliance, which produces oil and LPG gas in a huge amount, can enter into the subsidized LPG market of India. So that is an important committee from the exam point of view. Another important fact from the exam point of view is that India is the world's 2nd largest consumer of LPG gas as a cooking source. Now this status has been achieved by India's push, which has been driven by the PM Modi's Ujjwala Yojana. Basically, it has been believed that due to the push given by PM Modi's Ujjwala Yojana, the India has achieved the 2nd position in the world for consuming the LPGs. Now when was this PM Ujjwala Yojana launched? Mention your answers in the comment section below. Let's move on to the next question. Which country is the chair of Kimberley process for 2019? There are again 5 options: China, Japan, India, Australia and USA. So out of these options, option C, that is India, is right answer for this question, that India is the chair for Kimberley process to 2019. What is the name of the cyclone formed in the Arabian Sea off Gujarat coast? Kind of tragic but also a kind of miraculous news. You will come to know about it as we proceed with it. So there are 5 options: Fanny, Fallon, Nilofer, Varda, Vayu. Out of these 5 options, the option E, that is Vayu, as you can see in the picture also which I have put here, that Vayu is the cyclone which is being formed in the Arabian Sea off the Gujarat coast. Now, why did I say that it is a miraculous news also? Because Vayu could have caused a huge amount of destruction in Gujarat, but fortunately it has not done so, and it has lowered down to a depression and caused rainfall in the various districts of Gujarat and thus relieving Gujarat of the heat. Moving on to the next question. Who among the following has won a gold medal at the Foxham Grand Prix 2019? So can you guess the name from this picture? So the name of this athlete is P.U. Chitra, who has won a gold medal in 1500 meters race at this Foxham Grand Prix 2019. She has recorded the highest in this season by completing the race in 4 minutes 12 seconds. Now the question for you is that where is this Foxham Grand Prix being held? So mention your answer in the comment section below. What is the theme of International Yoga Day? And the answer is the option D, that is climate action. First fact about International Yoga Day is that UN is going to celebrate or observe this day on 20th June with Yoga with Guru campaign, and it will conduct a panel discussion on June 21. That was first information. Second information about International Yoga Day is that it is being observed on 21st June worldwide, and UN is observing it on 20th June. Where is National Zoological Park situated? There are 5 options: Maharashtra, Delhi, Arunachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand. I am not going to tell you the answer. You guys have to tell me the answer in the comment section below, since it's the comment time. Now, why this National Zoological Park is in news? I will be telling you the reason. The reason is that this zoological park is devoid of its giraffes, and the last giraffe which it had, that is 8-year-old Ankit, had died in 2015. So now this National Zoological Park is completely devoid of giraffes, and it has written to Thailand or requested Thailand for a giraffe exchange program. So that is the reason why this National Zoological Park is in the news nowadays. So do mention your answers in the comment section below, that where is this National Zoological Park situated. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel if you have learned anything from this video. Thank you so much for watching the video.